Hello everyone, welcome back to another video on Aspen Tech channel, and today we will design an air-cooled heat exchanger. So far in our previous videos, we have designed a shell and tube heat exchanger in Aspen Plus, Aspen Hisys and Aspen Exchanger Design and Rating, and plate and frame heat exchanger in Aspen Exchanger Design and Rating. And today we will design this heat exchanger type in Aspen Exchanger Design and Rating. So we have been given the tube side specification that the temperature of inlet is 120 degree centigrade, outlet is 40 degree centigrade, operating pressure, which is in absolute, is 5 bar, flow rate is 90 tons per hour, which means 90,000 kg per hour, pressure drop allowable is 0.15 bar and estimated is 0.3 bar, fouling resistance is 0.0001 square meter Kelvin per watt. For the outside tube specification, which contains air whose flow rate is 2000 tons per hour and air gas dry bulb design temperature is 25 degree centigrade, allowable pressure drop is 0.002 bar, fouling resistance is 0.0001 square meter Kelvin per watt. And in this tube side specification, we have hydrocarbon, and which include propane, propylene, 1,3-butadiene, anhydrogen, and hydrogen is involved as well. And these are the mole flow rates, or you can say mole compositions. That of propane, it is 0.022. For propylene, it is 0.006. For 1,3-butadiene, it is 0.368. For n-butane, 0.594. And for hydrogen, it is 0.01. So let's quickly go back to Aspen Exchanger Design and Rating and design this type of heat exchanger. So we will click on this new, and this one at number 5 is air-cooled. Expand it a bit and create it. And now this window is opened. As you can see, there are different options like design with fixed outside flow, design with varying outside flow, rating checking, and simulation. So we will design with fixed outside flow of the system. And this interface is similar to what we have already seen, but obviously these are configuration parameters, the properties are obviously different in the system. So what we will do, we can go to this problem definition, same heading remarks in application options, program calculation mode is design with fixed outside flow instead of US, it is SI. Tube side application phase change, outside tube application is dry air. We are considering dry air in the system, although the humid air or wet air can also be considered in the system. Then going to this process data, and first we need to change the units here. Now in tube side, we have been given that it is 90 tons per hour, the inlet temperature is 120 degree centigrade, the outlet temperature is 40 degrees centigrade. We have not been given any information about the vapor mass fraction. The operating pressure absolute is 5 bar and estimated pressure drop is 0.15 bar. It has given us the value, while allowable pressure drop is 0.3 bar. If it has changed, just simply convert it to 0.15, and fouling resistance in the system is 0.0001 square meter Kelvin per watt. And in the outside stream, we have been given dry air, so I will first write the name as dry air. Here it is 200 tons, 200 and 1, 2, 3, 200 tons per hour, and air gas design bulb temperature for inlet we have been given as 25. There is no information given about it, that about the minimum ambient temperature, altitude above sea, inlet pressure gauge, inlet pressure absolute, but we have been given the allowable pressure drop, which is 0.002, and fouling resistance, which is 0.0001. in the system. Now going to this property data, as we have known, we have given the problem definition, there is no crossover here, but we have not specified any tube stream composition. So obviously there are different options, and we will select this Aspen properties, and we will specify our required parameters or the required components, which are propane, propylene, 1,3-butadiene, hydrogen, and n-butane. So click here in Aspen properties, and after a bit pause, obviously that is not included in the video, click on this search bank, which will appear, and it is propane. First we will search propane, and propane is here, add selected component. Then number 2 is propylene, and we will find it as well. Propylene is selected. Then next one is 1,3-butadiene, we will find it, and it will be available as well. Then n-butane is selected, and it will be first found out, and then the last one is hydrogen. And obviously hydrogen is easily available. So you selected components and first change it to mole flow rate or percent, because we have been given in the mole flow rate percent. Now what are the values given? 0.022, 0.006, 0.368, 0.594 and 0.01. So I will quickly add it from here, like 0.022, 0.006, 0.368, 0.594 and 0.01. So these are the same which we have taken from here, and in property method Pangrobenson is already selected for the system. So we have given the minimum requirements or the requirements which we needed to specify for successful running the system. So click on run and wait for few moments. So now results are available, and as you can see, the optimization path has been run and 15 number of points have been selected, and for the current selected case it is 15th point. Then going to the recap after design, API sheet can be checked in the system. Then in thermal hydraulic summary, performance can be checked as well, the heat transfer, the pressure drop system. Then in the exchanger data, the exchanger data can be checked, and the setting plan layout. And if I just click, and it has been zoomed, and you can see the specification of the system, tube length, bundle slope, then each dimensions have been calculated in the system, the fan dia and everything. Then in the tube layout, you can see the flow direction has been selected, the bundle width, the height, and the cost has been calculated for the system. So this is how an air-cooled heat exchanger is designed in Aspen Exchanger Design and Rating. This is a very basic example of Aspen Exchanger Design and Rating, but obviously we can add a bit complexity in the system, but obviously that will again be a part of our upcoming videos. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel Aspen Tech. I have just seen the views. It is quite astonishing to see that most of the views are given by people who are not subscribing. So please do subscribe the channel, because obviously I'm trying my level best to provide you high quality videos. So it is a request to please subscribe to the channel, because 69% of the views are coming from those people who have not subscribed to the channel. So please subscribe it, please like it, please share the video, and do provide your valuable feedback in the comments, and I will try to answer each and every comment or suggestion provided in the video. If you have any query, or if you want me to make a video on a specific topic, you can inform me as well. Thank you so much. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned.